light is the way we first encounter the world, the wider world beyond our immediate touch. And whilst most vision is concerned with the light that's coming off surfaces, my work has been concerned with often with the light that's falling onto surfaces. My first postgraduate research was modelling the light from very distant galaxies. So when I began working in buildings, it was a great surprise to discover that daylight in buildings was modelled using a very simplistic notion. And so I began work on what became known eventually as climate-based daylight modelling, and that is something which has underpinned my work now for the past 20 years.
Here at Ickworth House, as in many of the National Trust houses, we've got lots of collections which are vulnerable to light fading and ageing. The problem we're facing is how to balance getting enough light that people can see and enjoy things, and that we're not fading or damaging things at such a rate that a lot of things will be lost to us completely in maybe a few years or decades' time.
In any heritage building, any heritage space, the light will vary enormously across the walls depending on the arrangement of windows and the time of day and so forth. If illumination is measured at all in these spaces, it will be just at one, possibly two points. Our techniques were showing the illumination across all the surfaces which were of interest in the space. So a comprehensive evaluation of the illumination conditions over long periods, over months or even years. We use a technique called high dynamic range imaging, where a camera is tethered to a computer which controls the sequence of exposures. Every 10 minutes, a sequence of exposures takes place, and from that, the computer creates a luminance image. This is the high dynamic range picture. And from that, we can get physical measures of illumination in the scene, everything that the camera sees with its wide angle.
So John's research has been really helpful for us to understand better the fall of daylight in those rooms and how we can learn to manage the shutters and blinds and keep the daylight out when we don't need it and provide as much as possible when the visitors are in so that they can enjoy the collection.